Well, welcome everyone to the webinar. Thanks so much, Chris, for the introduction. Today, we're going to be looking at an overview of the SOLIDWORKS Costing tool, which is a tool designed to encourage lean manufacturing early in your design process. And as he had shared, my name is Jordan Kleinschmidt. I'm an application engineer in the Minneapolis Eden Prairie office here in Minnesota. Really excited to stir some interest in a relatively underutilized SOLIDWORKS professional tool. So our agenda for today is as follows. First, I'm going to be covering what is SOLIDWORKS costing and what can it evaluate. Then I'll be going over the backbone of the tool and how you can get accurate cost data at your fingertips. We'll then see a multi-body part that is made up of several components, weldment bodies, sheet metal bodies, and also standard bodies. And we'll be able to see all the different options we have to evaluate these bodies as parts and how they go into that multi-body part or assembly. And lastly, we'll talk about the tool that drives it all, the SOLIDWORKS Costing Template Editor. Okay. So let's go ahead and get the ball rolling. What is SOLIDWORKS Costing? Well, SOLIDWORKS Costing is an evaluative tool that allows you to make manufacturing decisions that impact the total cost of your parts and your assemblies. This gives the designer the power to consider cost to manufacture before the design is released, something that's not always inherent in a SOLIDWORKS design environment, as you may know. Costing breaks down the cost to produce into both material and manufacturing costs, which allows the designer to focus on either or both to reduce the cost. So for example, if 70% of the cost to produce is going to material, I might want to try to find a different material to limit the cost that I'm putting into this part. The tool accurately tabulates data from customized templates. And not only can do that, but it also integrates directly into the SOLIDWORKS user interface. Its automatic report generation can both create simplified estimates and detailed reports for internal use. It also allows you to consider what-ifs early on in the design process to encourage lean manufacture and price optimization. And as we all know, lower cost always means greater profits. SOLIDWORKS Costing includes several manufacturing methods, as you see here. Sheet metal, weldments, machining, injection molding, casting, 3D printing, and especially purchase components. I think it really excels at evaluating sheet metal and weldment components personally. So how does costing work? Well, costing is controlled by the Costing Template Editor. And namely, there's three different templates that are used to kind of help organize and order information for the costing evaluator to seek out. These templates are divided into three templates. We have our main, our sheet metal, and our machining templates. We're going to talk about these more in depth a little bit later. All right. Costing also interprets bodies as parts by the design method that's used. So if we have standard features, they're going to be understood as machined, injected, cast, or 3D printed, while weldment bodies are going to be evaluated as structural members and so on. Okay. And these parts undergo unique feature recognition to determine cut methods, cut paths, and things like sheet metal bends to associate costs and values with that. Lastly, it's important to understand that costing is available with SOLIDWORKS Professional and Premium licenses. Pro licenses can handle multi-body parts just fine, but Premium licenses can also evaluate assemblies. The difference of those is mostly just movement at that point. You can do quite a bit with even a pro license. For example, we'll take a look at our multi-body part we'll be working on today, a stepladder. The stepladder is unique because it contains many different types of parts that all can be evaluated in the add-in. If we take a peek here, we can see our weldment features. And we have those orange weldment bodies there, which are just some configured pipe from the ANSI inch folder from default SOLIDWORKS. We have our sheet metal features, our machined or possibly even molded features. We'll see about which one we can choose when we analyze our what ifs. And lastly, our purchase components, right? In this case, these rubber grommets here. So now that we're there, let's go ahead and launch up the Costing add-in. We can actually find that under the Evaluate Command Manager, and simply by clicking the double arrows here, we can launch Costing. And being that we're in a multi-body part, we should get something that looks a little like this. And right at the bottom, we see a body list of how SOLIDWORKS is understanding these components as being manufactured. We see weldment and sheet metal components. We also see a list of different standard features. You can also see a list of all of the bodies and operations associated on the left-hand side. I can click and make changes to how SOLIDWORKS is understanding this manufacturing method. And I can maybe toggle that between machining or plastic. I'm going to keep it at plastic and make sure that I have this polycarbonate ABS selected. I can also do things like make sure that this is understood as a purchased cost. So if there's no value assigned to it, I can add a custom value assigned to it. Maybe we can say, let's say we buy these at a lot at about 8 cents per component. So I'm going to go ahead and type in 8 cents. And once I'm ready to go, once I've made all my decisions with the body list, I can go ahead to that green message there and hit begin cost estimation. All right, and we get an estimated cost per part automatically pretty fast as well. And it actually breaks us down into material and manufacturing prices. So if there's any sort of anomaly compared to what I'm used to with the same line of products, maybe that would be where I'd call to attention first to try to get that lean manufacturing down first. So let's go ahead and analyze the weldments in this structure. There's a few things that we can do with weldments. Today we're going to be talking about evaluating costs by doing what ifs on different types of material, you know, analyzing whether we should use aluminum or steel. And we can also evaluate design parameters and consider our design intent and then use available shop stock lengths to build our design around. Let's go ahead and just see just that. And I start with the structural bodies because on the left-hand side, the command manager there, you actually see that it's quite a bit more expensive for all of my structural bodies in comparison to everything else. So if I expand that, I can actually see one anomaly. And I double click that, it enters into my single user environment. I can see all of the different parameters that Costing has assigned to this body. Here we have aluminum alloys. I can run a different material through this here. So I'm going to actually select steel here. And steel has a lot of different implications as the designer is going to make it a lot more heavy, of course. So it actually gives you a little weight calculation at the bottom as well, which is really nice for understanding all of the different aspects that go into this model. We want a light ladder. Just for sake of this demonstration, I just want to keep the price low. And so in this case, I'm going to set the material to plain carbon steel. Okay. Other things we can do, we can consider different weldment profiles. So we maybe want to go and see what it will look like if we use one scheme of 40 pipe and the price difference for there. Okay. So we have the ability to kind of toggle between those different profile configurations. I also have the ability to select cost per length, which measures US dollars per foot, or per stock length. So this will actually measure the amount of waste when I actually make these cuts. Here I have a 10-foot size here, but my model length is just beyond that. So I'm just going to make a slight change really quick to the sketch. And here we have it all already update to that slight change. And we've saved 46% just by using an incrementally smaller stock piece in our inventory. Once I'm happy with that, I can go ahead and go back into my environment and save those changes and keep on trying to whittle away costs associated with this manufacturing application. Okay, so that's the weldment bodies. Let's go ahead and take a look at how we can analyze sheet metal and so forth. First, we're going to modify how sheet metal operations are fabricated, and we'll see how we can firsthand make overrides so that the accuracy of the component is spot on. We'll also be able to see how we can allow custom tools such as form tools or library features to be estimated within the sheet metal. So you can bring all of your custom form tools and library features into this and evaluate that accurately. We'll also be able to see how nesting options come into play to estimate the cost per body of the sheet metal component. So here we have, again, we're back in the multi-body environment on the left-hand side here. I'm just going to go ahead and start diagnosing these one by one. I can use this lock to set a baseline price, essentially as a price to beat. I'll double-click this here so that I can put that into my my single-body environment and start analyzing that. We get a similar-looking costing template task pane. Things we can do here, things like cut paths. Maybe we want to analyze a different type of cut path for maybe a cheaper operation cost. Here I see that the 86 cents to carve out the entire shape is clearly the most expensive. So maybe I want to see if there's a better way to cut that, whether it be plasma or water jet. So I can simply just right click that and I can actually say, hey, let's see what water jet does. And that's at actually 8 cents per inch. And that shoots the price up quite a bit, so I'm just going to stick to laser here. Okay, and as for bends, sometimes you have this uniaxial bends in the sheet metal component where the bends might not be the same price associated. So I can choose to get rid of some costs and apply a no cost to some of these as well. I can also grab my library features, and here it's SOLIDWORKS is saying, hey, there's one stroke, but there's actually four of these little punched rib features here. So as a designer, I can either try to diagnose what's going on here, or I can simply just do a price override, and I can multiply that number by four, and I have the accurate representation for my punch applications. Other things I can do is see what ifs on maybe changing gauge thickness. And what that'll do actually is not change the actual parameters of the design itself, but just evaluate it at a different costing point. It'll throw up a warning sign to let you know that this is different than what is actually in the model. I'm going to just change this back to the appropriate thickness because we didn't save any money there. Other really cool things I can do is look at the blank size. So we're evaluating this from the material weight and the bounding box, which actually will evaluate all the waste inside of that bounding box, whereas flat pattern area includes no waste at all. It will give you the lowest price, but it might not be accurate according to what's going on in your shop. The most accurate is probably sheet size. Here I can specify all of my different sheet sizes from a predefined sheets based off of the material and thickness that this is set as. If I do sheet size, I see that my cost shoots up astronomically, and that's because there's only one part per sheet and I'm wasting 73% of that metal. Okay, something I definitely want to change, so maybe I'll consider using a larger sheet size, or maybe I'll consider changing the design a little bit better. Here I've reduced the percent scrap a lot more. Let's go ahead and just try our last one, and this inevitably gives us the lowest price as we have 10 parts per sheet. I can show the bounding box nesting, see how that all fits. Or maybe I simply, like I said, change the design parameters to just be a little bit smaller of a step to minimize that waste. For sake of demonstration, again, I'm just going to select the flat pattern area. I can choose to lock this price and go back into my multi-body environment. Okay, I'm going to do the same thing with all of the other sheet metal bodies, just kind of update those according to what would actually be more realistic. And we see we have reduced the price by 11% since setting that baseline at the bottom right there. So now let's go ahead and look at our machined parts and also custom operations, how we can apply custom operations to the multi-body part that we're working with. So standard features may be evaluated as CNC milled, turned, injection molded, die casted, 3D printed even. And so that's what we'll be able to see with this next application. And we'll also be able to see how we can apply custom operations to accurately estimate costs. So I'm going to go into my general bodies here, and if I double click this, I'll take a peek at this. And basically I'm comparing, you know, is this going to be better machined or molded? If any of you have any experience with that, I'm sure you're going to know that molding is going to be a much cheaper option. But let's go ahead and take a peek at just what machining does here. We'll evaluate all the cuts, form a bounding box around that, give you a value for what you need for the actual box there. And we're at about $47 to have this CNC milled for one of these here. So definitely much too expensive. We'll stick to my regular plastic here. But we can do other things with the components too. So since we have a mirror image of one, we can likely just make this mold kind of be the exact same thing. So here we have a number of cavities. We can also have a total number of parts, which actually distributes the mold cost divvied up between that 1,000 parts. So that's how we actually get the mold estimate. So with this mirrored component, right, if we can make the same mold, have the mold have both of these components, we can alleviate some of those extra manufacturing costs. So here I'm just going to go in and remove the load and unload setup time because it's already being accounted for in that first mirrored image. Or in the first part there, excuse me. Once I've gone and made these changes, I'm actually able to save 15% just by changing the way that we are manufacturing this. The next step I would want to do, so considering these weldment bodies, give it maybe a branding or to call it out, we want that orange paint to be all around the weldment bodies here. So I can assign a custom operation, and custom operations exist within this folder here, as you see. So I can simply just right click and add a custom operation without even needing to go into the template editor. And I can go ahead and give it a name. And I'll name it orange paint here. And I'll give it a setup cost as well. Say just $5 over 1,000 parts. And maybe it's a tenth of a cent per inch squared, right? Because we're painting a face. So we're able to actually measure the surface area and be able to get a really good estimate for how much paint supplies we'll actually be using here. Once I am good to go there, I click OK, and it simply just hangs out within our custom operations. So I've fully costed this assembly here now, and we're able to save about 14% just by going through that process there. So by now, this is all good to go, and maybe this is the first rendition of, you know, of our part. Now it can be released and manufactured and hopefully capitalized on for additional lean manufacturing practices. So next, we're going to talk about the template editor, and that's the backbone that drives all of this data that you see here. Okay, and our costing is only as accurate as the information that we feed this template. So we do have our main template here, which is can include markups or discounts, can evaluate actually the costs of welds if you add welds in your assemblies or parts, and it can also create custom properties that are associated to price or cost. So here is what the costing template editor looks like. We can choose between what units we're using, what currency we're using, and assembly operation costs. if you go up to the top here, it's nice because you can actually open these up in like little tabs so you can work between all of the different templates. I'm going to go to a custom operations now here. We can also add a custom operation that will affect the system as a whole and be able to be selected. So maybe I'll add maybe a heat treatment here, right? We're working with metal. So I'm going to go ahead and add a heat treatment. And I can choose whether the cost is going to be divided per part, per inch squared, per volume, whatever it might be. I'm just going to select per part here and just submit a value for the actual cost. Can include a setup cost, how long it takes me to actually set one component into the oven, and how that cost is distributed. I'm going to say it's going to be applied once per part. And here I can choose whether or not I want that to always be included. I'm going to hit no because I don't want it to always be heat treated automatically. Here we have weld beads, which is really cool. If you use welds in your designs, you can add all your different weld methods. And what that'll do is it'll take all of these different weld symbols that you might also use. We have ANSI and other basics as well. Their weld bead types, sizes, and their associated costs with that. And what it'll do is it'll measure the length of each of those welds that you add. You can even export them in Excel if you want to make sure if you want to utilize that. For purchase components, I can add component names and associated costs, but I can also add custom properties and store these within my file properties in SOLIDWORKS. I have purchase price here and price here. And those are associating between my purchased goods, okay? My in-house goods is cost, total cost. And if I evaluate an in-house good and save this cost, total cost, I can really easily reference it again. That way, when I include it in an assembly, SOLIDWORKS will say, hey, there's a price already here. I'm just going to fill this value in instead of manually asking for it or possibly even machining it. And that was something that we did kind of earlier in the process of selecting those bodies and purchase goods. So we can save ourselves some time there. Okay, we also have a sheet metal template. And here we can actually separate, these are actually separated into different material and manufacturing operations for clarity. All the stock types for like sheet sizes and everything that we saw for selecting a sheet size and comparing that with those nesting options, those can be added to the templates as well. And additionally, we can add multiple cut and bend operations based off of, you know, different wall or different sheet metal thicknesses or different material thicknesses, right? We have all different costs associated with that there, and we have the option to control that in this template here. So here we have, again, our general tab, where we can choose a unique markup to sheet metal, or we can go into material and define everything that we have in our shop for being able to use. Here we have all the thicknesses that those materials come in, and we can export that in Excel as well, which will make it a little bit easier for you to interpolate all of this data. It's quite a bit. All the material and thicknesses go in, conglomerate into cut operations, and now you can associate costs with those cut operations. You can associate costs with those bend operations per material and thickness, and quite a bit more. In the machining template, we can also allow export to Excel spreadsheets, but it works a little bit differently in the fact that we actually add machinery like startup times and operation times and then calculate the material removal rate of that machining component to really get a good estimate of how much this component is. So here's our machining tab, and again, we have our default markups that might be specific to machining. You can have these default go to whatever percentage of markup you need for your margins. Here I can specify machining, and I can say here are all the different materials that might end up in my CNC mill, that might end up in my drilling or turning applications. Here's where I can add material for plastics, okay? So the injection molding and different costs associated with hot runners or cold runner mold styles. Same for casting. This is pretty much the same as plastic, except it's metal. Then we have our structural members here, which are our weldment bodies, okay? So it's going to read our weldment profiles and properties there, and we can associate a lot of different things there. US dollars per stock or US dollars per foot. You know, are we taking the stock length and cutting it down, or are we just going to try to get an estimate for roughly what the goods are going to be? We can also export in Excel to get that benefit there. Under machine, this is where we add all of those different operation setup times and associated prices to get the best estimation for material removal rate. I won't cover too many of the other ones, but I will cover the custom operations. This is available in all three templates. If you have operations that are associated with this custom or with machining parts only, this is where you'd store that, and the same for sheet metal as well. So custom operations associated with sheet metal, you're able to really categorize these operations unique to whatever tools you're using here. Okay, if all of that template editor looked like a lot, well, we do offer our own consulting as well. So you'd get what that is we'll not only just we're not just going to build the templates for you. We're going to help you build the templates according to your application. We're going to help you also understand those templates and how to use them and how to make changes and how you're supposed to work in that process. So definitely if that template is looking like maybe not your forte, but this tool is still something that you can greatly benefit from, definitely take a look at our consulting and get a hold of a salesperson, because we do offer a few unique packages to help you get the ball rolling on this. Okay, lastly, I just wanted to thank you all for attending. Again, my name is Jordan Kleinschmidt. My contact information is all right over here. If you have any questions, just let me know, hit me up, and I'd be happy to try to answer those as quickly as possible, or even contact your salesperson to learn more, or see how a demo would work with your particular application. Additionally, if you want to follow me on LinkedIn for additional SOLIDWORKS content, I'll post blogs typically quarterly and a lot of other good 3D manufacturing solutions content. Again, thank you so much.